Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dutch Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And this here is the Gap RC Cinequeen. Yeah, Cinequeen 4K, actually. So this is a 3-inch propellers, cinematic quadcopter. And you don't even need an action camera for this one. You can either order it with the Roncam Hybrid 4K or the Caddx Targier. So both 4K split cameras, if you will. And both of those will have two lenses, like this one over here. So basically this setup is two cameras in one. You've got an FPV camera and an HD camera. So I've had this quadcopter for a couple of months and I've done a lot of flying with it. And therefore it's time to do a long-term review, which is this video here. Yeah, and actually let me cut to an onboard recording straight away so you can see what it records. So the Cinequeen I have has the Roncam Hybrid 4K option camera. And I think that the footage you can record with the Caddx Targier is more or less the same. Maybe the color depth is a little wider of the Caddx camera. But me personally, I chose the Roncam version because I think it's a bit more reliable. Yeah, both of them have nice FPV cameras, by the way. Very nice, actually. So I had not flown on this at this location before, and you might notice that it's pretty windy. Yeah, you can see that from the flags and the trees. No, not the trees. There's no leaves on the trees, but it's very windy. And more on that later. Obviously, this quadcopter has propeller guards, right? Which has benefits, which comes with benefits, but they also catch the wind. So yeah, this quadcopter might not be the ideal quadcopter to be flown on high wind days. And in the Netherlands, we do have a lot of high wind. And in the Netherlands, we do have a lot of days with a lot of wind. And yeah, so for instance, now you can see that I'm kind of flying sideways. The camera isn't pointed straight forward. I hope you'll be able to see that. I think it's pretty evident. So that's caused by the propeller guards catching the wind. Yeah, I'm not even sure how that works, why, but it's definitely something this particular quadcopter shows. I've never had that in any other quadcopter. It's definitely a result of it having propeller guards. So yeah, just something to keep in mind, and I'll get back to that in the pros and cons section of this this long-term review. But also, it is very easy to keep this quadcopter off of the ground somehow. You can throttle it very precisely. That also means that the ESCs are precise. There's not a lot of deviation between the ESCs, and in lower grade bad 4-in-1 ESCs, you will see that. Now, regrettably, this first flight will end in a tree, as you'll see in a minute. Don't worry, it got out of the tree unscathed. However, the propellers, as you'll see in a minute, did get scuffed up. Which is, I guess, part of the test. In the rest of my flights, I will be flying the quadcopter with scuffed propellers. And you will not be able to notice that the propellers might be vibrating a little. There will be no jello whatsoever. And to that, I should add that I am recording this video in 2.7K, 60 frames a second. So if I would have recorded this flight in 4K, 30 frames a second, there might have been jello. That would have been possible. So keep that in mind. For the Caddx version, you can get an ND filter. For the Roncam, and there we go, we are caught in a tree. Yeah, so second flight here. No problem at all, and now that I am flying with a scuffed propeller. Again, for the Kenix version, you can get ND filters or one ND filter. For the Runcam version, you can't. There's no ND filter available for that camera, so you wouldn't be able to fly the Runcam version on a sunny day at 30 frames a second. Well, you would, but you'd see jello, most likely. Okay, so that was a first impression of the recordings of this quadcopter. So, Gap RC's Cinequeen 4K, and I think that these quadcopters from Gap RC look great, and I very much appreciate that. These quadcopters don't simply have a top plate, a bottom plate, and some standoffs like a lot of other quadcopters. They have a nice, well, aluminium extrusion at the front and the back. And that not only makes the quadcopters look nice, it's also strong. So, yeah, again, I definitely do appreciate their effort to make the quadcopter look good. And that not only goes for this one, but for instance, the CX3 Cygnet I reviewed last year had more or less the same frame and looks great in my humble opinion. So the CX3 didn't have prop guards. This one now has prop guards and a more modern FPV split camera. So in this video, I'm mostly gonna give you the pros and cons of this new version, the Cinequeen. I have already done a first impressions video, which I will link to up there. If this quadcopter is new to you, I'd encourage you to watch that video. Far more information about the specs and such of this quadcopter. Again, this video is pros and cons. I've also recently done a flight impression video with this quadcopter, with an onboard recording, obviously. And I will also link to that up there in the upper right corner. Again, I'd encourage you to watch those videos if you want a full impression of what this quadcopter is capable of. So, pros and cons of the Gap RC Cinequeen. Actually, before I begin, two things of note, so not a pro or a con. There were two things I noticed about this quadcopter when I got it flight ready. First of all, the RSSI channel of your receiver is set to the wrong channel. At least on mine, I have the XM Plus, so the FR Sky XM Plus version. And again, the RSSI channel was set to AUX 12. Yeah, it was set to AUX 12 and it should be set to AUX 14. Otherwise, you won't have RSSI. Not a huge problem, obviously, but you do need to keep that in mind. Second thing, again, I have the version with the Runcam Hybrid 4K. And if you were to order that camera bone stock from Runcam itself, it would be set to 2.7K, 60 frames a second. That's its default setting. However, Gap RC sets it to 4K, 30 frames a second, which isn't horribly wrong or anything. But again, if you were to fly the quadcopter on a sunny day, that doesn't really work out super duper well. So be mindful of that. I've set mine again to 2.7K, 60 frames a second. And yeah, that way you can record nice footage on sunny days. So that's two things you will need to keep in mind when setting this quadcopter up. At least if you have the XM Plus version with the Runcam Hybrid. Then pros and cons. Let's start with the cons, actually, why not? So the first thing, it comes with this battery strap, and it's a long battery strap. As you can tell, it wraps around the entire quadcopter or the frame and then around the battery. And that basically works out pretty well. However, if you are fumbling around, putting your LiPo in place, hooking it up and keeping the wire in place, then that strip will fall to the bottom like so. Yeah. And this is super duper annoying, basically. You need an extra hand to strap your battery down because of this. So yeah, something to keep that battery strap in place would have been very, very nice. So yeah, might be a minor thing, but I've flown this quadcopter quite a lot and it's a nuisance every time you fly the quadcopter. Again, it won't fly any worse because of this, but yeah, it's a bit of an annoying feature of this quadcopter, I guess. Other than that, the battery does stay in place just fine. The strap itself is not a bad strap in any way. It's got a metal buckle, as you can tell. It's stitched and it's anti-slip, so the strap itself is fine. However, yeah, the setup of it being wrapped around the frame and not being held in place when you, again, fumble around with the lipo is a bit annoying. So that's the first con of this quadcopter. Then the second thing, that might be obvious, but this is an analog FPV quadcopter. And since approximately a year ago, we've got that DJI system, which I don't have, but I know that it's a better experience. So yeah, that DJI digital system does not record in 4K, so that is also a benefit of this quadcopter, I guess. But again, your FPV experience will definitely be nicer, better with that digital system. Just so you know, this is old tech by now. I do very much enjoy flying the analog FPV quadcopters still, no problem at all. But again, if you invest a lot more into a digital system, it'll be more enjoyable to fly. There's no two ways about it. Then the next thing, the propeller guards. And those propeller guards are a pro and a con, both at the same time. So they catch the wind, as you could see in my previous part of the video. Sometimes the wind catches the quadcopter at an angle and you'll be flying along like so. And this is exaggerated, but you will be flying slightly at an angle, and it depends a little on the direction of the wind, obviously. But sometimes you'll be flying along like this, but sometimes you'll even be crabbing along like so. So be mindful of that, and yes, you can remove the propeller guards. But on non-windy days, they won't bother you much at all, basically. Yeah, in fact, on non-windy days, they offer the benefit of being able to power through at least small branches. Yeah, and I'll include a little clip. And one of the first flights of this quadcopter, I actually tested that by flying through, again, small branches. And you can hardly notice that you are flying through those branches. Now, at a certain point, you'll encounter branches that are thick. Yeah, the propeller guards won't help you out on those. However, they would still protect your propellers, of course, if you run into anything at all. And let me see, the last con of this quadcopter, at least con that I found, is that the ribbon cable of the Runcam Hybrid 4K camera sticks out at the bottom of the quadcopter. Actually, if you don't do anything about that, you will be landing on that ribbon cable, which is, nothing short of horrible. The ribbon cable is one of the most delicate parts of your quadcopter. You definitely don't want to damage it. You'll lose your FPV feed, at least. So hopefully you'll be able to see that I've stuck some rubber feet at the bottom of my quadcopter. The quadcopter actually comes with a couple of strips of adhesive rubber, or rubber with an adhesive side. So I've made landing feet basically for the quadcopter of those. And with that, the quadcopter has been durable. So I guess this helps. You definitely need to do something to protect that ribbon cable sticking out at the bottom of your quadcopter. So with all that said, you'd be wondering why I actually even like this Cinequeen from Kepa-C, right? Lucky for all of us, there are a lot of positive sides to this quadcopter as well. First of all, again, I think it looks great. And not only this Cinequine, but all GAP RCs in this line of quadcopters with this space frame, with the aluminium extrusion at the front and the back. I think these look great, which is nice. It won't fly any better because of that, but you also want to have something that looks nice. Obviously, when you're spending this amount of money, you want it to look nice as well. And the second thing is that with a quadcopter like this, with a split camera, it is super duper convenient. You just hook up the battery and you're set to go. You are recording in 4K or 2.7K in my case mostly. But super duper convenient, right? You don't have to charge a separate camera and make sure it's in the right setting and click so that it records. This quadcopter will always record if you take off, and actually in your FPV feed you can actually see that it's recording. Just in case you forget something, maybe your memory card or something, you will be notified. So that's super duper convenient. You'll always have your HD recordings. Then the third thing is that the flight times are nice and long. Maybe not as long as the Cygnet, so the quadcopter without the prop guards basically. So if you'd want to extend your flight time to maybe around 10 minutes, you can, but you'd have to remove the prop guards. So that's a possibility. With the prop guards, your flight time will be, well, 7 minutes. At least if you're not raging around with the quadcopter, you can do 7 minute cinematic flights with this quadcopter, which is nice and long, I think. Then somehow the electronics, so the ESCs and flight controller and its settings, not unimportantly, work out brilliantly, I think. I've changed nothing. And yeah, if you are buying a ready-to-fly quadcopter and maybe you aren't familiar with PID tuning or the other settings of Betaflight, basically if you choose the right LiPo, the flight battery, and that would be approximately an 850 milliamp hour 4S, you'd be set to go. It would be a perfectly flying quadcopter, at least in my case. And I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that. This propeller looks horrible. Again, I'm not sure if you'll be able to see that in the video, but there are chunks missing from this propeller. Yeah, I'm not sure in which flight I damaged this propeller. This propeller over here is also damaged, not as much, but definitely also damaged. This one is horrible. In most quadcopters, you'd see that in the onboard footage. A propeller looking like this, you'd have to exchange it. However, somehow the PID tune of this quadcopter swipes that away. The quadcopter still flies perfectly, and actually most of the recordings you've seen in this video, I had the propellers look like this. So the entire setup, again, of the ESCs and the flight controller and its settings work out brilliantly, in my humble opinion. And the last pro of this quadcopter is that it's proven to be very durable. So that doesn't mean that you can't damage this quadcopter. However, I've had a lot of crashes with this quadcopter so far. Yeah, there are dings and scratches here and there, but it's definitely not damaged. The propeller guards are still, well, these are my first propeller guards. Again, that's not to say that you can't damage these propeller guards or the arms or the frame, but again, I've even crashed it multiple times on concrete, and again, there are some scratches here and there, obviously, but it's still perfectly flyable. I haven't had to change anything. Yeah, for good measure, I'd probably have to replace this propeller, but that's it. That's it. So, those are the pros of this quadcopter, and I think with all that, it's a very, very nice quadcopter. So, in conclusion, would I tell you to spend your hard-earned cash on this GAP RC Cinequine 4K? Now, obviously, it depends on what's important to you, what pro and what con weighs heavy for you. So, you'll have to make up your mind on that yourself. However, if you are looking for a high-power freestyle quadcopter with a recorder, I'd say that this isn't it. If you want to do Mr. Steel videos, for instance, could be, why not? Then this isn't the quadcopter you're looking for. However, if you are looking for a relaxing quadcopter that can shoot nice HD footage of smooth flights, then this is definitely a very nice quadcopter. As you've seen in my recordings, it can shoot very decent FPV flights. And that's it, basically. I hope this video helped you out. If you are left with questions, hit me up a comment down below. Thank you very much for watching. Catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.